Ladies and gentlemen, we are presented with Denzel Washington's Kevin McCall in The Equalizer, directed by Antoine Fuqua. Now we get The Equalizer 2, where it spins off or follows what The Equalizer did, where he now is trying to help people by being a Lyft driver, so when there's any injustice, he steps in and does his own badass way to help people that are in need and people that really can't get any justice. But at the same time, his friend gets killed in action and now needs to uncover what really went on and really kind of digs into his past a little bit more. And what I would say in this movie is a lot of things, but the one easy thing you could say is that Denzel Washington crushes it. And that's really easy to say because anything you put Denzel in, or most things you put Denzel in, he has a great role and he really commits to any character you portray him as. And it's especially prevalent in a lot of Antoine Fuqua movies like The Magnificent Seven and more famously, Training Day. And if you haven't seen any of these films, you know that Denzel and Antoine Fuqua really work together. And the one thing I like about the first Equalizer film is that they really explored his past without giving us too much information. So we kind of figured out certain ways and certain things about his identity that made him a mystery man. And the action sequence that corresponded with them really made sense, or better yet, added some weight to it. So we kind of appreciated his character. In this movie, I enjoyed his character a lot. They do bring in the same relevancy to the first one, but it's hard to make a movie exploring someone's past while, you know, trying to make it a mystery, and it kind of blurs the line a little bit, but at the same time it kind of makes it a bit boring. I don't really like this movie and the portrayal of Kevin McCall. It really isn't as interesting as the first one, but at the same time there are other things that really make this movie not as great as it's supposed to be. But let's actually get into the positives, because we got to start off this review with a positive note. And the one thing I would say is that the action sequences are really great. The movie does a lot of justice, and the way it's filmed, the way it's lit, the way the action sequences or set pieces look, I like the way they portray the action in this movie, and Denzel really brings some flavor into it that really makes it original. But some of the subplots that are in the movie, as well as the main plot, really hinder on the issues of why this movie does not work tonally, emotionally, or as a plot. Some of the subplots I kind of enjoyed, and the one I really liked was the one where this kid, he really doesn't really know where he fits in. He joins a gang, he has some issues, but he wants to be an artist. Denzel kind of has this father figure on him to help him, you know, get him on the right path. Instead of doing the drugs and being a gang member, he guides him on a different path. And I like that dynamic. I like that subplot. It really added what the Equalizer would do. And it's not just being a badass, but just being a badass emotionally and just mentoring people. But at the same time, there are other subplots, like with this old man who's trying to uncover this painting and his past. I felt like that plot was a bit, you know, loosely interweaved in there. Certain stories like that I feel like don't fit in this movie, but really the main plot of his friend getting hurt and killed and that whole uncovering of what's going on in the CIA and where the Equalizer or Kevin McCall fits in all this, that is really hindered toward the third act of the movie. And I enjoyed it, I had a lot of fun with it. I felt like all these plots and all these ideas just thrown on the screen really don't fit together as a movie. And the mystery of all of it, which is what the Equalizer really had going for it, really is hindered and really doesn't bring anything to it. And even the villain really doesn't grab my attention. It's a villain that I saw coming maybe a mile away, but at the same time I feel like this villain just, he didn't add anything to the flavor of the movie. He didn't really bring anything that was menacing and condescending. While I would argue in the first one had a far better villain who was the match of Kevin McCall. So whatever he did, Kevin McCall did. That back and forth banter and the back and forth action that these two players had, that looked amazing. It just was a great contrast and who and what these characters' motivations are. It really blew my mind and how they did it. But here it just seems like a revenge story that really didn't have the greatest villain. But if you sit back and relax in this movie, you would have a fun time. It's a bit slow. Like the first one, it takes a long time to build. I believe the first one took 30 minutes just to build his character and the story to progress it, and I felt like this one took way longer than that, and it felt like sometimes I was just dazing off, just wondering when either when this movie is gonna end or when it's gonna pick up. And when it picks up, it's great, but you know, there's a lot of downtime in between these scenes, and I wish the movie really had a better pace and, you know, more action filled than I would say it had. It was really story holes and plot holes and issues with the story that really didn't make this movie great. And that's all I gotta say about the Equalizer 2. Bottom line is, Equalizer 2 really does do a great job of, you know, just a laid back action movie that you can understand and enjoy. But at the same time, I feel like this movie isn't quite up to par with the first Equalizer, or better yet, it's just not up to par at all. I feel like this movie missed a lot of points for the story and how the story really progressively slows down. But if you could just sit back, relax, and honestly just enjoy Denzel being Denzel, you would have a great time. That is my review for the Equalizer 2. It's really late, I know, but that is up with you guys, ladies and gentlemen. I like this movie. I hope you guys check it out, at least have a little bit of, you know, fun in the movies. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace and deuces, whatever it is. I'll see you guys. Boom.